Hello, good morning everyone. I am Dr. Manoj Kumar N.B., working as an associate professor in the Department of Management Sciences, Maharaja Institute of Technology, Mysore. So in the previous session, we had discussed about what are all the roles of commercial bankers in the social and economic development. And the subject title titles Banking and Financial Services, the subject code is 18 MBFM 301. So today we are discussing about the unit 2, commercial banks. In that we are discussing about the services of commercial banks. So the services of the commercial banks are categorized into 18 different services. So namely, we have credit cards, ATM services, debit card, home banking, online banking, mobile banking, acceptance of deposits, priority banking, and also we have a private banking. Also we have the left side, advance of loans, overdraft facilities, discounting of bills of exchange, check and check payment, credit instruments, foreign currency exchange, consultancy or agency services, banker's guarantee, and remittance of funds. So today we are mainly concentrating on these 9 services. So in the next session we are going to discussing about the rest of 9 services of commercial banks. So we are moving to the first one, where the first one with respect to advancing loans. So advancing loans refers to one of the important function of commercial banks. The public deposits are used by commercial banks for the purpose of granting the loans to individuals or businesses. The commercial banks grant these loans in the form of overdraft, cash credit, and bills of discounting of bills of exchange. So then when we come to the first one, the advancing of loan, where a bank lends to a certain percentage of the cash lying on deposit on higher prices, higher interest rates, then it pays to the depositors. So obviously the loan rate will be higher than the deposit rates. This how the banker can able to earn the profits. The banks advances loans in the following manner. The first one is cash credit. So cash credit, it is the type of loan is granted to the businessman against certain specified securities. To a new customer, the loan amount has to be opened from where the money is due. Is withdrawn by the check, but he pays interest on the full amount. So therefore the cash credit is a loan which is sanctioned to the individual, and sometimes for businessman, whatever they are specified the securities, against to the securities the bankers are going to be raise the loans. Then the second one under the advancing loan is call loans or money at call. Call loans are money at call, or also we call it as short notice. They are very short term loan means it might be 3 months, 6 months or 9 months. It is very short, mostly given to all brokers for 15 days. They are advance against first class securities. So it is very short term, so therefore it is less than a 1 month. So it is 15 days time period. It is going to be given for against to the first class securities. This is this can be called as a very short notice. Then overdraft facilities. So overdraft, as we know that the customer, he can able to claim whatever the sufficient balance is available, more than the sufficient balance. Even though there is no sufficient balance also, they can able to claim more than whatever the balance is available in the particular account. So therefore, the overdraft is a facility extended by the banker to draw a sum greater than the balance lying in his current account. The businessman is charged interest only on that amount by which his current account is actually withdrawn. Current account actually withdrawn and not by the full amount of the overdraft sanction. So therefore, the partial amount is going to be claimed, not the entire amount he can able to claim at the time. Then coming to the fourth one under the advancing of loan is discounting of bills of exchange. So it is an improve of financial liquidity of any company exchanging the promissory notes receivables for cash. So therefore, it is a greater extent to the business people. They can able to retrieve whatever the amount they need immediately, they need in the urgency, they can able to make it into cash. So if a credit cards want money immediately and has a bills of exchange, the banks gives the money by discounting the particular bills of exchange. So the banker deposit the amount of the bill in the current account of bill holder after deducting the rate of interest for the period of the loan, which is normally not more than 90 days. So therefore it is a stipulated time period of 90 days for any bills of exchange. So therefore, normally the banker is going to be provided within the 90 days. So any of the day we can able to claim by surrendering whatever the check or bills of exchange we are received to convert into cash. But banker have a right to claim that one after the maturity period of 90 days. So when the bill matures, the banks get the payment from the banker. So therefore, whoever the debtor is going to be make a payment, otherwise the banker will ready to go and collect the cash from the debtors. Then discount of trade bills. So the discount of trade bills is a short term granted by the bank. The bank purchases trade bill before its payment term at a price less the amount of discount interest. The bank discounts bills submitted by the drawee, which is credit card, of the principal amount and holds a settlement account at bank's Millennium. So therefore, they are going to consider how they can able to make a claim for whatever the amount they are going to be received from the banker. Then discount of these trade bills is available in two variants. The first one is as a single transaction or under a discount loan. So that is upon granting renewable credit limit for discount of a number of trade bills within 12 months after repayment of bill by counterparty, the available limit is released. So therefore, they can have a two chance. One is single transaction, so means at a time itself they can able to make a discount of trade bill, or else they can make it into 12 months. So within the 12 months, the balance will be upgraded. Then benefits of these discounting of bills of exchanges, you will, as a customer, as an investor, you will have a gain to a competitive edge thanks to ability to offer your trade partners more attractive payments condition with longer payment terms. So therefore, when you need a better bondage between the debt cards and credit cards, you must need to have a very good rapport between the whatever the system you are maintained with respect to payment and collection and all. So therefore, you can easily meet that requirement by choosing the discount of bills, and you will also improve your financial liquidity and economical ratios thanks to all your receipt for your receivable. So therefore, you can easily plan towards how much to retain and how to meet the liquidity and how to maintain the economic stability in the company. That you can able to properly plan if you use the discounting of bills. And you may move from sales based on credit conditions like trade credit into cash sales discount. So therefore, when you are given a much offer, much discounts and all, surely you are going to make better cash sales rather than depending on the credit sales. And you mitigate the risk level related to the debtors default. So this is the most important one. Whenever think about the organization, majority of the organization, they do the business based on the credit basis. When they do on credit basis, what happened? They are going to concentrating on even on debtors. So they need to be value the debtors. They must need to be continuously, they must need to do the collection by the debtors. Unless they are not have a better collection period, they couldn't able to make the payment period. So therefore, they must need to be very careful regarding to the collection period and payment period. Unless there is a mismatch, if they are having a mismatch between these two, surely they are not going to be have a better business networks, better business relationship are going to be breakdown. Then coming to the next one is collection credit instruments. So where collection and payment of credit instruments. So where credit creation is one of the most important function of a commercial banks, as we discussed in the previous classes, in order to earn the profit, the banks accept the deposits and advance loans by keeping a small cash in reserves to meet the day-to-day needs of the customer. So therefore, the banker should need to be maintain a proper liquidity with them, and the remaining whatever the deposit they are collecting and whatever the reserves they have, they must need to be used for providing or advancing a loan. So therefore, when they are providing more loans, it will be generate more revenues to the banker. So out of that revenue, whatever the depositor they have, surely they can easily make a interest on whatever the deposit they got. And when a bank gives a loans, it opens an account in which the name of the loan taker and does not pay him in cash, but allows him to draw the money according to his requirement by granting a loan. The bank creates credit or deposit. So here it is also one of the mode that whatever the dilution of the funds, it is not going to be taken place when they are granting a loan through bank accounts. So whatever the requirements of the individual investors or the individual customers, they are going to be claimed whatever the requirement of cash limit. So means they grant the loan of 10 lakh rupees, but all 10 lakh rupees they are not need not to be claimed at the time itself. Whatever the commitment, whatever the responsibility they have, like 2 lakhs, 3 lakhs, 4 lakhs, depending on the requirement of the individual, they are going to be claimed the whatever the loan which is sanctioned. So therefore, the manipulation of the funds or misusing of the funds are taking some limitations here whenever they are granting a loan through accounts. Then coming to foreign currency exchange. So commercial banks helps in the foreign trade by financing its customers and by accepting the foreign bills of exchange. The bank encourages the documents like document against acceptance and document against payments for foreign payments. Further, it transacts the foreign exchange business and buys and sells a foreign currency. Most of the times, whenever we do the business in the foreign country, we are going to be convert our domestic currency to foreign currency or foreign currency to domestic currency. So therefore, the banker plays a vital role with respect to foreign currency exchange. So therefore, it will give you a lot of insight towards how to make more profit with the fluctuation of the foreign currency rates in the global market. So therefore, that is also one of the way that not to just focusing on earning a better profits, it is also focusing on how to make more profits with respect to using or exchanging the domestic currencies into foreign currency or foreign currency into domestic currency. So therefore, any type of such businesses who are established in the foreign countries or foreign country businesses are established in India, those will be take consideration of particular commercial bankers who are helping them towards foreign currency exchanges. Then coming to the next one, we have a consultancy. So consultancy, as we know, that it is a agency services. So agency services, as we know, that the banker play as a intermediary role between the businesses and customers. So a bank discharges agency services on behalf of its customers, which are as follows. So we will go one by one, where the first one here is the bank collects payment of bills of exchange, checks, dividends, etc. on behalf of its customer. So sometimes we given the standing instruction or whatever the clients we are going to do, whatever the payment or receipts we are going to do, that is directly going to be remitted to our bank account. Even for whenever we do purchase of properties, we must need to be given the checks. Those checks are linked to your bank's account. So therefore, those also going to be considered towards one of the agency services provided by the bankers. And it buys and sells the shares, securities, debentures and for its customers. As we know, most of the bankers, they are doing the portfolio management where they are going to be buy and sell the securities behalf of the customers. So sometimes they also makes the customers to make a right investment and right return, they are going to be given a more chance to the investor to make an investment into portfolio investment. And the bank remits money to different places by bank draft on telegraphic transfers on behalf of customers. So as we know, earlier we have a telegraphic transfers. So now we also have a account transfers, mobile banking we do transfer. Earlier we have any draft we are going to be transferred through telegraphic mode. So that is also one of the services which is served by the commercial banks. And it is also discharges the functions of marketing, work as a trustee, administrator or executor for its customer. So as we know, sometimes the nominee, if something happened to the account holder, the nominee is going to be benefited. Something happened to the, if the client is minor, then the authority will be goes to parents. So like the same, the banker is going to be considered as a trustee, as well as they are considered as administrator. Also, they are going to be take care of executor accounts. And it gives a proper advice to the customers in the matter of correspondence and other matter of businesses. So therefore, whenever they are grant the loan, the bankers are very careful regarding to whatever the progress of the company, operations of the company, ownership in the company. These are all the things they are going to be observed by the commercial bankers, and they are going to be advised towards whatever the business decisions or business matters. They are going to be keep on involved in that, because most of the bankers are supporting the business in the right direction. So therefore, whenever they do take a decision with respect to financial matters or economic matters, production matters, they do discuss with those projects with the bankers. So therefore, that will be helpful for them in the future to grant much more loans, and that will be helpful for them towards achieving the greater task. Then coming to the next one is that is banker guarantee. So banker's guarantee refers to a promise provided by a bank or any other financial institution that if a certain borrowers fail to pay the amount or fail to pay the loan, then the bank or the financial institution will take care of these losses. The bank will assure to take care of such losses. The bank will assure the original creditor through this bank guarantee that if the borrower does not meet the particular his or her liabilities, then the bank will be take care of them. So therefore, the banker's guarantee is most important when they go for imports and exports, because as a outside country person, he is not going to believe you, he is ready to believe your banker. So therefore, this kind of the services also rendered by the commercial bankers. Banker guarantee will be assurance given to the sellers or suppliers that the debtor's banker is going to promise that whatever the money which is liable or responsible to or meet by the debtors, the banker given assurance that in case of any lagging or any non-payment of the particular amount, then the banker given a guarantee that I am going to pay the such value. So therefore, the banker guarantee makes assure to each and every suppliers towards go for foreign imports and exports. So therefore, this is one of the major document which is required in the international trade. A bank guarantee is a contract. It is an agreement between three different parties, and they includes the first is the applicant. The applicant is the party that requests a bank guarantee from the bank and borrows from a creditors. So means the person who borrows from the creditors, he go and approach to the banker to provides the bank guarantee. That's the first person. Then coming to the second person, the beneficiary. The beneficiary is nothing but the party that receives the partial guarantee. So means who receive the assurance from the particular banker, that we are called as the beneficiary. Then the third one, the bank. So the bank is the party that agrees to sign and assure the payment in case of the applicant fails to repay the particular loan. So therefore, three parties: one is debtor, the person who is liable to pay to the supplier, is approached to the banker to provide the banker guarantee. Second one, the person who is going to beneficiary, that is a supplier, so therefore he is going to receive the partial guarantee from the bank. And the third one is the bank, who is assured, who is promised in case of any losses, in case of any fails to repay the particular loan amount, then the banker is going to be given a assurance. So therefore, these three parties had an agreement that to fulfill the particular transaction. So therefore, the bank guarantee, which is helpful to the international trade, and it is more than the promissory note, that the promissory note which is carry based on the debtor's capability and convenient banker. But in case of banker guarantee, the suppliers will be a safer side, because the banker is going to make a payment. The bank's guarantee are very commonly utilized among business entities. So as we know that most of the business corporations, they are business entities, they are mainly use this bank guarantee as one of the tool in the exchange or to do the businesses. With the help to the bank guarantee, the debtors or borrowers or customers, we call it as, will be able to purchase equipment, machinery, raw materials, and acquire additional funds. So such all the services they can take place through for commercial purposes. So therefore, for doing a sales, for doing a business, for doing a their own specific type of organization, whatever they are required, to purchase the equipment, machinery, or any type of assets and operational tools like materials and all, they can able to do for the commercial purpose by having a bank's guarantee. And bank guarantee, which is help businesses as creditors, will get a proper transaction that the loan amount will be repaid by the bank. If the bank, if the businesses is unable to repay the loan entire on time, so therefore we are not going to pay partially, we are going to pay full. So when we are going to pay full, the banker given assurance to the supplier. So therefore, even though the debtor are not in the position to repay it, then the banker is going to pay that amount at the stipulated time. On right time, they are going to make a payment. Then when bank signs a bank guarantee to promises to pay any amount according to the request made by the borrower, hence signing the bank guarantee implies a high risk for banks. It is a very high amount of risk to the banker, because unless or until they are not critically evaluated the borrower or the customer, then whatever the amount they paid at the stipulated date to the creditors, they are unable to get the claims from the debtors. So therefore, they should be very careful with regard to providing the banker guarantee to the any customers or debtors or any borrowers. They must need to be very careful regarding towards make a payment or make a assurance, to give assurance or to make a guarantee towards making facilitate the particular payment. The banker should be very careful regarding to it. Then under the bank guarantee, and to understand the process of bank guarantee, there is several steps which is involved towards getting the bank's guarantee. The first one here is the applicant will ask for a loan from the beneficiary or creditor. So therefore, as the applicant will ask for whatever the account number or whatever the beneficiary have a loan, that one the applicant need to be approached to the banker. So therefore, the first condition is to an applicant will ask for a loan from a beneficiary or creditor, and the while applying the for the loan, these two parties will agree that the bank guarantee is necessary. So therefore, both the parties should need to be agree. So first one is both the parties, the borrower must need to be asked the loan from the beneficiary or creditor, and the second thing is where both the parties should need to be agree to undergone with banker's guarantee. Then the applicant means the borrower. The borrower will request a banks to provide the bank guarantee for the loan taken from the creditors. So therefore, whatever the credit taken by the creditors whatever the loans which is received by the creditors by the borrowers, so the borrower is going to ask to produce the or to provide the banker guarantee in his bank. Then the bank guarantee will be taken on behalf of the creditors. So then the bank will now offer the bank guarantee to the applicant and send the financial instructions to the advising bank. So therefore, then once they are sent to the creditor's banker, then the amount will be transferred to the borrower's account. So therefore, it is a very smooth way of doing the bank's guarantee. So in the bank's guarantee, we have a around six types of bank guarantees. The first one here is deferred payment guarantee. So this refers to a bank guarantee or a payment guarantee that is offered to the exporter for a deferred period for a certain time period, which is when a buyer purchases capital goods or machinery, the seller will give a credit to the buyer. When the buyer banks gives a guarantee that it will pay unsettled dues of the buyers to the sellers. So therefore, under this type of guarantee, payment will be made in installment by the banks for failures in the supplying raw material, machinery or equipment. So therefore, in the deferred payment guarantee, whatever the unpaid amount which is left out by the borrowers, that amount which is going to be paid by the bankers. So therefore, that is the assurance or that is the guarantee which is given by the banker. Then the second one is financial guarantee. So financial guarantee assured that that money will be repaid if the parties does not complete a particular operation entirely. According to the financial guarantee agreement, when there is a delay in the completion of the project, bank will make the payment. Sometimes within the stipulated period, the operation which is not completed, the performance will be have an inefficiency. At that time, we must need to do the payment. So unless if they are not fulfilled the particular transaction or the operation, then the banker is going to make a payment to the creditors. That we call it as financial guarantee. Then advance payment guarantee. So under this guarantee, advance payment will be made to the seller. There will also be a guarantee that if the seller fails to deliver the service or the product accurately or promptly, the buyer will receive the refund of the payment. So therefore, here in this guarantee, the name only indicates advance payment guarantee. So the banker will do the advance payment here. So in case of seller, in maybe a delay in the supply, or if there is a damage, or if there is no proper delivery of the product at the particular time, at that time, the whatever the advance payment which is done, if the seller is failed to reap the products or services, then that amount will be revert back to the borrowers. Then coming to the next type is foreign bank guarantees. So foreign, I already said, in the foreign exchange, the bank guarantee plays a major role, because unless we produce the banker guarantee form, nobody is ready to do the businesses. So therefore, a foreign bank guarantee is provided by bank on behalf of the borrower. This will be offered on behalf of the foreign beneficiary or creditors. So therefore, so the creditor will be a foreign beneficiary. So then the domestic banker is going to be given a banker guarantee on behalf of the customer. So therefore, for easy, smoother the way in the foreign trade, the banker guarantee helps to them. Then performance guarantee. So under this performance guarantee, compensation on money will be made by the bank when there is any delay in delivering the performance or operation. Payment will be made even if service is delivered inadequately. So therefore, the timing is most important. If whatever the timing which is framed, whether the task is completed or not, it is must that task should be completed, the operation or the transaction should be completed. In case of any inefficiency which is found, incomplete transaction, inadequate transaction, then also the amount will be transferred in the performance guarantee. Then bid bond guarantee. So bid bond guarantee, here under this type of guarantee, there will be a supply bidding procedures. So this will be conducted by the contractor for the owner of an infrastructure or industrial project, or any kind of operation, the contractor, the project will be guaranteed that the best bidder or the highest bidder will have a capability to authority implement a project as per her preferences. So the bid bond will be given to the owner of the project as a proof of guarantee, and bond will be implied that the project will have to deliver according to the bid contract. So therefore, here it is a promise that the bidder and the contractor, they are going to be achieve the best with respect to it. Then remittance of funds means they are going to be provide, or they are going to make a payment with respect to any such payment like electricity charges or water charges, LIC premiums, all these things they are going to make a payment through the bank account itself. So therefore, these are the major services. Today we are focused into the main 9 different services we are focused. So hope you are understand these 9 different services of commercial banks. The rest of the commercial banks services we are going to discuss in the next session. Thank you for your listening. Thank you, Anidav.